Friends, distinguished guests, and honorable Motilal ji and the team of JITO trainers, I am so happy that you have selected London for this gathering. London is not only a beautiful city, but it's a good place to live. When the revolution took place in Iran, we brothers went all around the world. It was Geneva, it was Canada, it was Washington, it was New York, it was France, Paris. Finally, we thought London was good for our children, for education, for living, language, and it's really a beautiful place, and would like you to visit as much as you can here. And moreover, it's a financial center. It's full of activity. No one can say, I can't make money here. Now, I have been asked to speak about my journey. My journey has not been an easy journey. It is a 60 years journey, which is not my alone journey. It is the family's journey. It is the group's journey, which started in 1919. Now it is over 100 years. And the biggest achievement the group has had was to have a unity in the family. And we believe the family bonds, the family values are something which gives you happiness, which gives you support, which gives you inspiration to grow. The total family, the group companies, they work on the principles of our father, which he laid down through his hard struggles and work. 1919 was the first year when after Pakistan, before Pakistan, he took a very aggressive step to go on barges to south of Iran. The reason he did this, because he believed that word is a bond and word is a commitment. Because of World War, he had a lot of commitments on textile, especially with Ahmedabad mills. And he committed that I am not going to declare force majeure. Where there are supplies, the demand has to be somewhere. So he took the most difficult place to go to Iran. He sent one brother to Karachi and one brother to Afghanistan. When we heard his stories, what a struggle. It was not an easy task to where we have come. He had to face the Jews who were making 4 rupees out of 1 rupee. And they wanted him to join the cartel. In those days, Indians were not well respected business people because they felt the quality will not be good. They will not honor the commitments. And the Jew cartel spread out everywhere in the bazaar that don't buy from this Indian, you will never get the goods, he will take the advance money and go away. But he was brave enough. He said, I don't need money, I will get the goods here, take the delivery. And he started to sell something what was 1 rupee at 2 and not at 4. And finally, the these Jew groups came forward and they said, Mr. Parmanand, why don't you join us also? He said, sorry, you have come here to make money and loot the country. I have come here to honor my commitment and cut my losses. From that he formed what is a bond, advance vigorously, aggressively. In that journey, at the age of 17, I used to be in Jain College. I was in the second year of my college. He said, Gopi, you have to go early morning at 7, finish your college at 11, be in the office at 11, and start to learn each and everything. This is more important than the education. And my friends, who after 11, when the college got over, they used to have programs for going to movies, they used to have programs for going to restaurants, luncheons, have fun, enjoy. They had their girlfriends, which I never saw in my life. And finally, after 1.5 years, 2 years, he pushed me to go to Tehran to help my brother, Gilbert, the oldest brother. Unfortunately, at a young age of 32, he passed away. And in 2 years, the total burden came on my shoulders and my brother, elder brother, S.P. Gopichand Hinduja. And it was a real challenge, because the father had created reputation. He had created an establishment. And we had to see how to give a growth. And he had decided at the age of 45 to go for philanthropic activities. Because when Pakistan partition happened, it was a real struggle for him. He used to be on the docks at Bombay for each and every refugee with a food of 7 days, try to find accommodation. He built houses. He didn't bother for business. In the afternoons he used to come, he had full faith in his sons, not knowing that still we are in learning stage. So the entrepreneurship came from there. There is no business we brothers have not done except tobacco, alcohol and casino. My good friend Lakshmi was talking about religion. I can tell you, we believe in all the religions. Because all the 9 religions, including Jainism, they all end into humanism. If you look at each and every religion's details, you will find the sum and substance is same, but the way of narrating is different. And especially nowadays, our babas and pandits have made up a business out of it. I can only tell you one thing. If you have blessings of your parents, there cannot be anything better than that. You should try and see how your parents, even if they are born old, you should try to give them the maximum support, maximum comfort. I remember when I got married, and my brother, as we both married on the same day. And we never went to a movie alone. We took our parents with us. And that used to be on Saturdays and Sundays. We learned quite a lot from our parents. Business side, his 5 guiding principles. What is a bond? advanced figures 3, growth with partnership, act local, think global, and without good partners, he believed we cannot work anywhere. He had an excellent instincts of adopting all the cultures. That is how today you find us in 48 countries of the world with a reach in 100 countries. Each and every time the struggle came by partition in Pakistan, by revolution in Iran, by riots in Lebanon where we had our offices, we were ahead of everyone to make a move. Now these were what? These were parents' blessings which gave us instincts to move ahead. And when again we came and made London as a home, we said, okay, now here we are babies. What will we do? In Iran, we were well looked after by everyone. We knew everything. In those days, I remember, the biggest challenge, the trade between India and Iran used to be 2 billion. We took it to 12 billion in 1 year. There is no Indian corporation, including Tata, Birlas, STC, MMTC. We formed joint ventures with them. The knowledge what we didn't have, we acquired with them and we gave them our local knowledge. When we came here, we said, okay, now we have a vision how to become multinational. The first thing we did was to acquire Gulf Oil from Chevron. Now, oil and gas was not our business. But we found a good team, good management, professionals. We went in. Then 3 years later, from British Leyland, we acquired Ashok Leyland. We found the team was good, management was good, the future is there. Lakshmi mentioned about Indian passport. Let me tell you, we brothers and the family have British passport, but our heart is Indian. I don't feel shy to say, the reason we went for British passports was travel. To travel in different countries and every time go and beg for visas was a big headache. And in those days, the black passport was not respected. The immigration officer would put 20 questions, which doesn't go in my nature. I never like to remain in queue. I just like to move forward. And I remember there used to be Tujhe rukna nahi, tujhe jhukna nahi, ghabra na kahin, teri hai zameen tum badhta chal, taaron ke haath pakadta chal. So these types of things kept me away. Now, we all the brothers are workaholic. We never understand what is pleasure, what is holiday. Believe me, I do go for holidays for a week, 10 days, but I start my work even in holidays at 6 in the morning, and by the time the children and everyone gets ready, I am ready with them to enjoy the holiday. But if I go more for holidays, then I am a lost person. In 2 days, I become dull. I get depression. My children tell me, Dad, you have achieved everything. Please take easy. Don't take life as if you are 25. I tell them that the father taught us one thing. Up till the end of your day, you should keep on working. Retirement is only once. when you can go to sleep at ease. Otherwise, you should always work. Sometimes I get surprised when people go for long holidays. And I say, okay, what are they doing? They wake up 10 in the morning, 11 in the morning, sleep 2 o'clock in the night. You all will be surprised. All the members in the family wake up between 4:30 and 5 in the morning. The ladies, my wife, 4:30, she gets up, 5 she is in the prayers room. I wake up at 4:45, I am with my BBC, Bloomberger, and 6 o'clock on my desk, 7 o'clock in the temple, 8 o'clock for my walk. Whether it is storm, whether it is snowfall or anything, because there are certain strong beliefs. Now, from where did they come? It was the upbringing. The mother was very spiritual, honest, high integrity, compassionate, equability, and she always believed that don't eat till you have served to others. Now, today the group has over 120,000 employees. Now, the work to give principle goes for everything. In philanthropic activities, I can tell with great pride, we have never said no for any charity. Maybe when the appeals come, I may not have met with their requirements, but at least I will send a check, small or big. Because the Hinduja Foundation itself is spread it all over the world, and we try to build up institutions which can be useful for others. We are proud of our Hinduja Hospital, we are proud of our Hinduja College, we are proud of Dharam Indic Research Center, which we started in Colombia as well as in Cambridge, to see how from old Vedic scriptures we can bring out solutions which can be useful and helpful for this suffering world. The world is full of uncertainty. We know one thing, that nothing is easy. I remember my 75th birthday, children had planned holiday resorts, costliest places and everything, and they had booked everything. In the morning when I got up, I was at my desk. I told to myself, GP, this you have been always doing every year. Let's do something different. A thought came to me. I rang up my brother Ashok, that look, my thought is, we want to go to Rishikesh, Haridwar, and spend my 75th birthday there with my friends and family members.